there are 7 different principles of universal design. The first of these is equitable use. Equitable use means a design must be useful and marketable to everyone. This principle brings attention to what we hope to achieve with universal design, inclusion. Along with the definition of the equitable use principle, there are 4 guidelines to ensure proper implementation. First, provide the same means of use for all users. Identical whenever possible, equivalent when not. This allows everyone to use the same features at the same time. For example, automatic doors that open for those who are walking, using a wheelchair, or rolling luggage. Second, avoid segregation or stigmatizing any users. Historically, the concept of separate but equal has not been equitable for all people. It segregates the person and draws attention to the fact that the person has a disability. Ricardo Gomez, a professor in the School of Design at San Francisco State University, hopes designers think of equity and including all users at every stage of the design.
One of the things that I've always been concerned with initially about adaptive or accessible design, it was separate but equal. And you say, well, okay, you've got a ramp over here and you got a stair over there. You can take the stairs and you can take the ramp. Well, that's not equality, that's not equity, because that's separate but equal. And coming from a historical background as an African-American, when you had so-called, quote-unquote, separate but equal, we know that there were tremendous shortcomings in inequalities, if not subordination, of those that type of approach. It all had to be all for one and one for all in terms of how we approach it in a very shared and inclusive environment.
Third, ensure provisions of privacy, security, and safety, which should be equally available to all users. Designs like family restrooms provide privacy and security for users who may need assistance. Safety is also important, so users are not injured when using a design. Bill Letty was able to incorporate this guideline for equitable use in the design of the Ed Roberts campus in Berkeley, California.
It was a big opening ceremony, and somebody pulled the fire alarm. There was no fire, but someone pulled the fire alarm. So the Berkeley Fire Department came in droves because they'd heard about this new building where all these people were going to probably need help being evacuated. When they arrived, everybody was sitting out on the sidewalk waiting for them to come. And they said, how'd you get out? And they said, well, there's that ramp. And so after that, I had several people come up to me and say, you know, this building gives me so much peace of mind, because every other building I've ever worked in, being in a wheelchair, I've had to be worried, if there's a fire, how do I actually get out? Can I get out? In this building, I can just roll down the ramp and I'm out.
Fourth, make the design appealing to all users. Designs can be visually appealing and bring together those who want to use them. However, it is important for the designs to be just as appealing in their function. In other words, designs should be marketable to anyone.
When we designed this building, we initially had worked with a different architectural firm before we hired Letty, Midham, Stacy. And we told them we wanted a ramp on the building, and so they brought us a design and had the ramp on the outside of the building on the back. And it was clear, this architect isn't getting this, doesn't understand, you know, what universal design really means. Bill Letty was the one who came up with the idea of, let's make the ramp the key feature of the building.
Some designs are equitable for all in such a way that have made universal design elements part of the mainstream.
And I think once people are using accessible technologies and they realize that many of the technologies that they use on a daily experience integrated into their phone came from accessibility, when they meet the people who use those technologies and then are able to piece together that it's the same technology that I use. So this person may use a magnifier, but I use Zoom in my phone all the time, that it then sort of breaks down some of those barriers.
You may find it is helpful to keep in mind that disability is natural. About 10% of the world's population has a disability. In fact, 1 in every 5 Americans has a disability, and this could be something a person is born with or acquires later in life, including aging seniors who may need assistance with their mobility, sight, or hearing.
At a core level, universal design is a way of thinking that levels the playing field for everybody and makes experiences and products accessible, usable, and, you know, also just fun to use for everybody.
This video was produced for the Rehabilitation Engineering Research Center on Technologies to Support Aging in Place for People with Long-Term Disabilities, RERC TechSage, and the Disability Rehabilitation Research Project on Universal Design Practices to Enhance Work Outcomes, DRRP on UD in the Workplace by the Center for Inclusive Design and Innovation, Georgia Institute of Technology, and Tools for Life, Georgia's Assistive Technology Act program. RERC TechSage and the DRRP on UD in the Workplace are supported by grants 90REGE006 and 90DP0049 from the National Institute on Disability, Independent Living, and Rehabilitation Research, NIDLR. NIDLR is a center within the Administration for Community Living, ACL, Department of Health and Human Services, HHS. The contents of this video do not necessarily represent the policies of NIDLR, ACL, or HHS, and you should not assume endorsement by the federal government.